Hi. Page Object Model is a design pattern creating an object repository for storing all of the related web elements in its own page class. So it is kind of like a layer and interface between the test codes and UI. Page Object Model considers each web page as a separate class. So we can call the methods or web elements about the page class using the same name. In the work environment, we may have dozens or let's say hundreds of classes and packages. And if any change is made on any web element, and if we are using, here is important, page object model, then corresponding page object will be updated only. But the whole suite will not be affected by that change. So the benefits are, let's say it is more readable and understandable with a clean coding, more reliable, reusable, maintainable, also saving time and workload as well, and also reducing code duplication. We can implement page object model by creating a Java class with page factory, and then by using find by annotation instead of find element method. Now let's discuss about how to handle synchronization issue. Let's suppose that we want to locate a web element but not load it on the page yet. In this situation, Selenium throws element not visible exception message. Why? Because our code runs faster than browser can handle. So we need synchronization because we want to make sure if our driver and our browser altogether are on the same page at all times. Here are three ways on how to sort out the synchronization problem: thread sleep, implicit wait, and explicit wait. Thread sleep method waits only for the given period of time. So it is not considered a good practice. Why? Because too much use of this method will extend testing time longer and make it slower as well. Implicit wait, on the other hand, specifies an amount of time if the web element is not present yet. And it throws no such element exception if the concerning web element is not found or not available in given time. So it defines only a single time. Explicit wait, on the other hand, tells the web driver to wait till certain conditions are completed, and then it throws element not visible exception if those conditions are not met. And it applies to specific single web element defined only, but not to the whole script. In conclusion, implicit wait may be more effective to use when web elements are located within the time frame specified, and on the other hand, explicit wait may be the best option to use when the web element on the page takes a longer time to load. Thank you.